I'm Richard Carlton. I'm here with Sam Barnum in this video.
Hello.
And we're talking about the 360Works email plugin this time.
Email version 2.
Email version 2. And so this works, what does this work? It works with FileMaker Pro.
FileMaker Pro, and it runs on the server very well. A lot of people use it on the server or just on a laptop. And
now, FileMaker sends emails out on its own. So why are we even talking about this?
Yeah, FileMaker has built-in email capability, and you can send a basic email as text and use an SMTP server or use an email client, which will open the message in the client on your desktop, and you can send it that way.
So for those of you who've been watching my training series, you already know that we've spent a lot of time learning how to do SMTP mails out. So they're pretty familiar with this. But the email plugin is really cool because it allows you to do a number of different things, including sending out HTML, you know, graphically enhanced emails out, which are really cool, right?
Yeah. And basically, if you need something beyond what FileMaker offers with its built-in capabilities, then we're going to offer that. And we offer HTML, we offer inline attachments, you can send multiple attachments with an email, and you can send an email to many recipients very quickly also, because you're not connecting and disconnecting from your SMTP server over and over. You can do a lot of bulk operations that way if you're spamming people. So
yeah, now exactly. And to give everyone an idea about this, the RCC free video campaign that we send out on a weekly basis uses the email plugin from 360Works very successfully. And so we're actually showing you products that we use ourselves on a weekly basis, so I fully endorse the use of this plugin. Now, one thing I wanted to show you today, and the reason why we're really doing this video, A, it's an awesome plugin, but B, we didn't know that this thing actually would send out SMS messages, right? Tell us about that.
And this is new in version 2, and you can send a text message to somebody's phone using AIM, AOL Instant Messenger account. So what you do is you would log in. If you can read this, you are imaginary.
There you go.
Perfect. Imaginary. So it'll happily send the message to any phone number you want. And then you don't need to know the carrier or anything like that. AIM will just proxy that along, and the person's phone will ding.
Now, in order to make this actually work, we actually had to use a AIM, AOL Instant Messenger account.
Right.
And so we activated account up here at the top.
And over here on the right is the account that we're using. And you can see also a bunch of buddy icons here. And the reason this is there is in addition to sending SMS, the email plugin will send AIM instant messenger messages. And it can send those out. And that's also a nice way to notify people. If you've got people on computers and you want instant notification, that's a nice thing.
So you could actually have script triggers in here that if certain conditions happen in a database, even behind the scenes, it could send out, you know, SMS messages. FileMaker Server could. I mean, at any given time, it could do that.
Yeah, definitely.
So this is tremendously powerful.
Yeah. And all we've talked about now is sending. And actually, one other thing I wanted to talk about that's new in version 2 is Amazon SES, Simple Email Service.
Now, I'm not familiar with this. Tell me, what is this?
Amazon hosts a lot of services lately, like they'll have a database or they'll host your application, and in addition they'll host your email delivery service.
Okay, so I'm familiar with some of it. You know, they'll host virtual servers and things like that, but yeah. I've not heard of this one.
So if you want to send email, typically you need an SMTP server.
Right.
And that's what's going to take charge of delivering your message to its recipient. If you want to use Amazon, you sign up for an access key from Amazon, and then you can use their servers to send your emails.
But they don't call it SMTP.
Right. They call it Simple Email Service, and they've got a lot of complicated kind of different protocols for sending the messages that it's not really SMTP, but they end up sending the email for you. And our plugin can use that. And that's a nice feature because for a lot of people, setting up an SMTP server is just a hassle.
We've got a whole video just about beating your head against the wall trying to get your SMTP settings set up.
Yeah.
In fact, Lee Lulucard has a database that you set your general parameters in there, and then it just beats the snot out of your SMTP server, trying all the permutations of port numbers and things, trying to figure that out, what can be worked.
And I use Amazon now to send my own personal emails. It always works. It's always up. Sometimes our other ISP provider goes down, and I just use this, it's nice. And also if you're doing a shrink wrap solution that you want to be able to send emails, that's a really nice portable way to do it.
So this is a good way of transmitting emails out. Mm-hmm. Do you receive emails this way or just transmitting out?
And that's something that FileMaker really can't do, is if you want to read email into a system, you'll really want this plugin because it makes it very simple to connect to an email server, either POP or IMAP. You log in, you get a list of messages. Again, you can read all of the HTML from the message or the plain text, or you get attachments. You can get inline attachments. You can move stuff around different mailboxes. You can really build an email client with it. And actually, if you download the plugin, we have a FileMaker email client that we wrote using the plugin.
Okay.
You can check and send emails.
Now, we've done that with one of our support systems where FileMaker is actually able to read the inbound support emails.
Yeah.
And we use the plugin for that. So that works very well. But most people don't understand, and I'll take just a quick moment to explain that sending emails out of FileMaker generally is pretty simple, straightforward affair, but having emails coming into FileMaker, once the email comes into FileMaker, the question is, what are you going to do with it? You know, because you have to know how to triage or take care of that email. How do you positively identify who it's from?
Yeah.
And then what do you do with it, right? And how are you going to route it? How are you going to take care of it? What if it's a spam about buying the latest box of Viagra, right? Then what do you do with it, right? How do you know it's Viagra ad, right? I mean, what are you going to do? So there's a lot of thought and care that has to go into triaging inbound emails, and people don't necessarily understand that when they say, customer calls and says, hey, I want to have a FileMaker read all my mail. Like, really?
Yeah.
You know what's in your inbox? Right?
And there's a lot of interesting things behind the scenes in just a simple email message, like headers that link things together in threads. And you can group things by reply and original message IDs and that kind of thing. And in addition, when you send messages, you can set custom headers with this email plugin. And that's all kind of on the more advanced side. But
Sure.
And if there's something that it doesn't do, then let us know. We're always adding features to it and improving it.
Excellent. Well, I appreciate the overview. And once again, so that's 360Works at 360works.com. And that's the email plugin.
Yep.
All right. Thanks.
All right. Thank you, Richard.